decimals. Good day, students. Previously, we learned about fractions. Let's have a quick review by writing down the fractions of these representations. Are you ready? Let us start. In the first one, we have 3 colored parts out of 10 equal parts. In fraction, that is 3/10. On the next one, we have 4 colored parts out of 10 equal parts. And that is 4/10. And finally, we have 5 colored parts out of 10 equal parts. And that is 5/10. Great job! But did you know that fractions can be written in another form? Yes, let's have an example. 3/10 can be written as 0.3. 4/10 can be written as 0.4. While 5/10 can be written as 0.5. These numbers are what we call decimals. Decimal is a fraction written in a special form where each digit represents different power of 10. Let's have an example. 3.5. Fractions has 2 parts. The first one is the number on the left part. They are called whole parts. While the number on the right part is called decimal part. And the dot between the right and the left side is what we call decimal point. The decimal point separates the whole parts and decimal parts. Now let's have a review of the place values. As we all know, whole numbers have place values. The place value of 3 is 1. If we add another number, the place value is 10. Hundreds, thousands, 10,000s, 100,000s, million, and so on. Decimal part has place values as well. We call them decimal place values. The place value of the first digit on the right side is pence. The next one is hundreds, thousands, 10,000s, 100,000s, millions, and so on. The number of decimal places is the number of digits to the right of a decimal point. Let's take a look at this example. 0.35. Let us count the decimal places. 1, 2. Therefore, 0.45 has 2 decimal places. Let's have another one. 0.5. Let's count the number of digits to the right of the decimal point. We have 1. Therefore, 0.5 has 1 decimal place. Last example, 0.451. Let's count the number of digits to the right of the decimal point. 1, 2, 3. Therefore, it has 3 decimal places. Now, how do we properly read decimals? Let's have an example. We usually read this decimal as like this. 35.451. But the proper way of reading this decimal is, first, we read the whole number. That is 35. We read the decimal point as end. And then, we read the decimal parts as 451 and add the place value of the last digit, which is 1. The place value of 1 is thousands. Therefore, we read these decimals as 35 and 451 thousands. Let's have another example. 2.09. First, we read the whole number, which is 2. And then the decimal point as end. And the decimal part as 9. Let's add the place value of the last digit, which is 9. The place value of 9 is hundreds. Therefore, we read this decimal as 2 and 9 hundredths. Let's have last example. How do we read this decimal? Since there is no whole number, we proceed to the decimal parts. We have 306. And then, let's add the place value of the last digit, which is 6. The place value of 6 is very good. It is 10,000. Therefore, we read this as 306,10,000. Well done! What have you learned today? Comment it down below. See you next time!